Yo, it's your boy Young, that's right, Jizzle, chilling right here with DJ Self, on Power 105, drop it one time.
Checking out that new DJ Self app, available on Google Play and iTunes. Exclusive videos, downloading all the new music, wow. And you can stream live on the radio to listen to me, DJ Self. DJ Self app, get you it. DJ Self, the Prince of New York. I do this from hood to hood, ghetto to ghetto, city to city. And you know we always keep it Gwinning.
Yeah, okay.
We are tunes in the building too, what's poppin'? Now listen, before we even start, I don't know how to do this motherfucking dance. I need y'all to teach me how to do the goddamn dance before we even start. Now Rico Love gonna be cool, so he gonna act like he don't wanna do the dance, but it's okay. You know what I'm saying? But y'all gonna teach me how to do this dance. Baby, you know what it is. DJ Self, the Prince of New York. It's Power 105. I got four gentlemen in the building. We are tunes in the building.
Hey, what up?
What's popping, man? Listen, now can everybody introduce themselves?
This Levi, man.
What it do is Crash Bandit.
Ladies, we me. What up, Calamo?
KB.
And we are tunes.
What's up, man? Now listen, where y'all from?
Atlanta.
What part though? Like, you know, Atlanta got all different parts.
Stone Mountain,
Jonesboro. We spread it out.
Yeah,
okay.
All
right, so just in case, you know, people are trying to wonder what I'm talking about, I'm going to play the record, then we're going to get back to y'all and talk a little bit, all right?
Damn.
We are tunes in the building, huh?
We got the whole world screaming out.
Rico Love's in the building.
Shout
the Rico Lover, Rico Love, take over.
You know what I mean?
Let's get the business out the way. Even though I don't like really doing like the interview stuff like that, you know, I like you just, you know, I like people to know the personal side of you and pause. But you know what? Let's take care of the business.
You
it's about
what?
The album. It's about these singles.
Yeah, man. The EP is officially in Best Buy's exclusive right now. Now this is not the album. It's a prelude, if you will. It's five songs that's very, very important to me. And what I did was I added an extra song, which is the Bees Be Like, which has got the streets on fire right now. And everybody's feeling
you know
the
what?
Content.
You know what? It definitely got on fire.
The memes for it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
On Instagram.
Yeah, everybody's kind of like.
And if Sleep posted one more time, I swear to you.
Sleep is Harlem. He representing. He got to really show that extra pro. Love to his little brother.
Every 5 minutes, though.
We need that.
I can't see my shorties butt naked flicks, you know what I'm saying? Because you're timelined it out.
Yeah, but you know what? It's crazy. We driving off the video this week. Tomorrow I'm going to 106 and Park to drop the video up. So I'm super excited about it and super excited about the message and everything that's coming with the music. And, you know, organically is how I'm putting the project together. And everybody is feeling, is just feeling it. You know what I mean? So it's good to get love and it's real. And not just because, oh, that's Rico and he did this and that. I think despite all of the success I've had before, I think people are really accepting me as an artist because they feel like it's real. When I listen to music, I don't feel like it's contrived. Homeboy ain't out here looking crazy and trying to be this guy that he ain't. He just a real dude who made dope music and just, you know, come from the bottom and really, really believe in making some dope content that's going to affect people.
Okay, all right. Now, let me ask you a quick question. This is going to be a question, but this is kind of maybe informational to some of the cats out there, right? When you write a song for someone, explain the process to the people out there, just in case some guys out there, because everybody think they can just write a song and then that's it.
You know what it is? It's important to say the most common thing in a way that's never been said before. So earlier, remember when I was saying that I wrote "There Goes My Baby" about watching a woman get dressed?
Uh-huh.
That's such a simple thing. So you gotta say that in a way that just like mesmerizes you. You know what I mean? Motivation. I wrote it about a woman trying to get you to help her climax. So instead of her just saying "ah," you know, she gave you a really cool, clever way of saying it. And I think that's the key to writing records. So if y'all out there, y'all songwriters, you can't just think I'm gonna write a song called "Do Me, Girl" and it's gonna be a hit. You gotta find a way to say that without saying it. You
okay.
know what I mean? That's the key. And I feel like the great ones, the Baby Faces, the Smokey Robinsons, the Marvin Gayes, you know, the Geniuses, you know, the guys, even the Neos and the Dreams and, the, you know, those type of guys who came and was able to write amazing songs that spoke to people and didn't say the obvious but found a way to say it in a clever way.
Okay. Well, you know what? I was more talking about business aspect.
Oh, business.
Yeah, the business aspect, but yeah, I man, like you gave some jewels on that
always,
one, too.
You know what I love? I love more than anything the passion and the true, you know, essence of music. Business is business. Obviously, you're going to make money, but at the end of the day, if I keep teaching people about money,
uh-huh.
that's all they're going to focus on, and they're
okay.
going to do it for the craft and do it for the love. You know what I mean? I want people to do what I do because they love it.
Okay.
It'll ruin the game if a bunch of guys is out here just trying to write songs and get a check.
Okay.
Which is really what's going on. It's what's been going on for a while now, but I think the substance is coming back to music in general. When you start mm-hmm. listening to guys like Drake and Kendrick and J. Cole, and you know, a lot of guys are making records with content, and it's really saying something. And more kids are starting to grow and lean towards those type of songs. I think that's cool. That's
okay.
better than just uh-huh. talking about getting money, because we all know we getting money. We can see it.
Salute to them. The reason why I was just asking you that, because sometimes I know I'm in the clubs or I'm walking out down the street, everybody just give me their song, and I'm just like, yo, you think you just make a record and then that's it? Like, do you got it on iTunes? Do you got your ASCAP? Do you got your publishing?
Yeah.
Like, they just making records and yo, just give it to me. You know, they want to crack somebody in the head because they ain't play.
You definitely
you know.
Got to have your business together. And I watched this webisode that Future dropped the other day, right? And he said something so real. He said, man, I've been grinding for 10 years before I got to this point.
Uh-huh.
And I'm still working. And you know, a lot of people, they'll get out here and move away from their house and try to hustle for 2 months and be frustrated and ready to give up. And
okay.
ready to tweet me every day and tell me why I ain't helping them.
Uh-huh.
There's so much work that goes into it. But behind the scenes, before you get an opportunity to have one meeting, you know what I mean? You had to sweep up a bunch of floors and go get a bunch of coffees and sacrifice and really humble yourself and just do the work for no money.
Mm-hmm.
So if you ain't ready to do that, how you expect to be a millionaire and really appreciate it? People see me, I'm not doing too bad for myself financially, but I work like I ain't got nothing. You know why? Because I had nothing and
mm-hmm.
I struggled and I loved it and I appreciated that grind. So I knew whenever I got a dollar, I was going to work like I ain't have nothing so that I could maintain and get more and more and more and more. You know what I mean?
Okay, all right, we're dropping jewels over here.
We got the whole world screaming out.